Good morning. Can you hear me? Good morning. Hello, guys. Can you hear me? Thank you. Okay, so I think as promised, tutor finished the grading and released the grade of assignment 2. So he also made an announcement. Over announcement, right? You can see that grade and marking scheme are released, assignment 2 are released, okay? Then if you have any questions, you can contact Zizhen for assignment 2. Okay. Yeah, so I think that's one issue related to the assignment, right? Another issue is don't forget today's tutorial, which is very important, relate to assignment 4. Okay, so basically is how to design kind of how to design multiple level or single level pre-table. Okay, so I guess we can start now. Yeah, I think yesterday we stopped here. Right? Basically, we gave example, then I think I didn't make it very clear. Okay. Before we continue, let me just simply talk about advanced page table. So. Yesterday, actually, the first issue we talked about is TLB. So TLB, the idea is very simple. Basically, we want to have a small buffer, which is on the CPU chip. So we can quickly get the mapping between virtual page number and the physical page number. For the physical page number, we call physical frame number. So the idea is that when we do this page table mapping, we have to go to the memory to find our PTE entry, page table entry, which is inside our page table, right? So if every time we do memory access, we need to go to the page table, then we have one more level, one more memory access in order to get our real memory access, right? First, get the physical address, which is stored inside our page table, right? From PTE entry, page table entry, then we get the physical page number. Then from the physical page frame, then we plus the offset, we get the physical address, right? So that's general idea. Then it's too slow. So TLB is very simple. Basically, we want to keep a small buffer. Then after we spend a lot of effort to get this mapping, we store it into this small buffer. Then next time, based on the temporal locality, spatial locality, it's very possible we may access the same page, then we can find this translation from TLB. So that's the idea, right? So certainly because this is small buffer, then we have to do replacement when it is full. Then we also talk about LRU, least recent use, and how to implement. Then of course, we also talk about because this TLB is shared among multiple processes, then how to handle it? So for usually when in TLB, we also have some bits to record, we call address space ID, ASI ID, right? So which actually is related to process ID, right? Then everything is okay. So that's the first issue we talk about. Then we talk about, after we talk about TLB, the performance related issue, we move to advanced paging. So the idea here is that page table may be too huge. Okay, for example, if we have a 32-bit address space, then our page table can be 4 megabytes per process. For each process, we don't do anything. We just store this page table. Then we need 4 megabytes, right? Then the issue here is that a lot of entry, a lot of PTE entry, you can see here are empty. But if we directly store the whole page table, then we have to store those entries. So we want to play the trade-off. Basically, we want to save the space. We don't want to spend too much memory space on this table. Then we go to the, we talk about hybrid approach, but as we mentioned, it's not very commonly used. So we go to the multiple level. The idea actually is very simple. You think about that. We still have page table here. Our one level page table is still here. So suppose every entry or every page of our page table need to be allocated into the memory. You can see, suppose this is the case. Basically, this is our page table. So we have multiple pages is used to contain our page table. Okay. Then for those pages only contain empty entries, we don't need to allocate the real physical page. So this is why you can see after we end this page directory, then basically we only need to allocate those physical page to contain our page table. For example, this one, and this one. We only have 3 physical page for our page table, okay? For other parts, suppose they are empty, or at this moment we don't need them, then actually we don't need to allocate any physical space. So that's general idea. So after we end this one level indirection, remember originally if we only have one level page table, this is our page table, we have to allocate all pages here relate to our page table. Then we, from our page table, then we can directly get our memory. Now, because we want to save the space, we can end a directory page. This page, through this page, then each entry will tell us, okay, where to find our physical page for our page table. Through this indirection, we can save the space. So in this case, you can see here, basically we only need 3 physical page. Okay, then of course, our trade-off here is that now when we do memory access, we have to first go to our directory to find the corresponding page frame which contain our page table, corresponding page table, right? Then go to that corresponding physical page frame to contain our page table. Then from there, find our PTE entry. Then combine with our offset, then finally do memory access. So we have one more level of interaction. Then the trade-off here is one more memory access. But don't forget that TLB. So think about that. Why we talk about TLB first, then we talk about this. This page directory, if we only have one page, right, for this page directory, actually this page will be put into TLB buffer. Very often, based on our LRU approach. Do you agree? What do you think? Because this suppose we only have one page, okay? One physical page for our page directory entry, right? Only one page. Then because this page is frequently used, so this mapping is frequently used, okay? Then we will keep this into our TLB. This mapping will be put into our TLB, okay? So basically, we can have this mapping, and for example, if we have three, then maybe we have this four TLB entries related to this mapping. So basically, we don't need to go to the memory to find it. So we already found the translation, and we can directly read it, right? So generally speaking, this is a good design, okay? TLB is good. Okay, so on the other hand, if our page table, you think about that, if our page table, every entry we need, right? We need to allocate one physical page. Then our page directory actually is introduced actual one page. But in reality, a lot of entry are empty, so we don't need to allocate the physical space. So then this is a benefit, okay? So I hope I make this clear. But anyway, so let's go to the example then. I hope it can be clearer later, okay? So let's look at this example, right? Suppose our address space is 16 kilobytes. Address space is our virtual address. Okay, this is determined by the programmer, right? So our system programmer say, okay, for the address space, we have 16 kilobytes. For example, in our IA32, our address space is 4 gigabytes, okay? So the first issue, this one address space determine our virtual address. You can see here, because our address space is 16 kilobytes, which is 2^4, 16 times 2^10 kilo, right? So we have 2^13 in total. So we have 14 bits. You can see this is our virtual address, 0 to 13, right? So this is our virtual address, okay? Page size determine our offset and how many virtual pages we need in order to satisfy our address space. Okay, so in this case, our page size is 64, which is 2^6. Okay, so our virtual address, you can see we have 0 to 5, we have 6 bits, right? So basically after that, this is our offset, which means after we determine a particular page, then we can utilize this one to determine a particular address inside this page. This part is total number of virtual pages we need for this address space. Okay, specifically, we have here, you can see in total, we have 14 bits. Then here we already need in total, right? We have 14 bits. Then we need 6 bits for offset. So we have 8 bits, right? This 8 bits here from 6 to 13, 8 bits are used to represent our virtual page number, Okay, in total, we need 2 power 8 entries, 256 entries, right? Okay, so if we directly store our pre-table, then that's it. We need 256 entries. So let's look at how many pages we need here. Okay, so then if we want to look at how many pages we need, then we have to look at what is the page entry size, each entry, right? How big it is. Suppose page entry PTE size, okay, each page entry size is 4 bytes. So this also determined by the system. Okay, usually it's 4 bytes. Okay, then you can see here, if we have 4 bytes, then how many pages, how many pages we can, Oh, in other words, okay, maybe we first let's calculate, okay. Let's calculate each page, right? Each physical page here, each page, how many PT entry we can get, okay? So you can see page size is 1664, then divide by 4, right? So basically each one we can put each page, physical page can contain 16 entries, right? Okay, for 16 entries, think about that, 16 entries, this is our offset. 16 is 2 power 4. So we have 4 bits. Suppose we have two level, right? Then we have 4 bits for our offset. This part is our directory, okay? And generally speaking, that's what we are talking about. Oh, another way we look at this is that in total, we need 256 entries, right? Then each page we can contain 16 entries. So how many page we need? Okay. 16 pages we need, right? Then basically, this is our offset. This is our page directory number, right? Inside our page directory, right? Basically, right? So 4 bits for page directory, 4 pages for the offset inside each page. I hope this is clear, but generally speaking, I think maybe let me go back to here to talk about this again. So first one, this one is determined by the page size, right? So this, how many bits for our offset is determined by the page size, okay? Then what happened for this part? Okay, suppose we have multiple level, then what happened after this offset, totally, this is our VPN, virtual page number, right? But if we divide this into multiple level, for example, two levels, how to handle it? Okay, then first we have to look at what is the PT entry size. Okay, then divide, use page size to divide PT entry, then we get, for example, in this case, our page size is 64 bytes, then our PT entry size, right? 4 bytes, okay? So we need 16 entries. So each page, what I'm saying is that each page we can contain 16 entries, okay? So then our first level, we need 4 bits as offset, okay? Other part is our page directory index. Okay. Similarly, you can if we want to have multiple entries, then you can use this way to decide which part is for page direct index, which part is for the offset. So why this is important? Then given the address, then you know which part you use to refer which table, right? For example, yeah, I think go back to this one. For example, after you determine this address space here, in this case, okay, let's use this one to explain again, right? Our this IE32, okay, Intel most popular architecture, 32-bit processor. Okay, so our address space AS, okay, I use AS to represent address space, is 4 gigabytes, 32-bit. Okay. Our page size, 4 kilobytes. Each one is 4 kilobytes, okay? Yeah. So this is our address space. This is our page size. So how many entries we need for our page table? 4 gigabytes divided by 4 kilobytes. Okay, so we need 1 mega entries, right? In total, we need 1 mega entries, right? Okay. So what is the PTE entry size? PTE, page table entry size. Suppose it's 4 bytes. Suppose, okay? In reality, also it's 4 bytes, okay? Then let's look at each page. For each page, physical page, right? Then how many entries, how many PT entry we can contain, okay? Each page, how many PT entry we can contain, okay? So we have 4 kilobytes divided by 4 bytes, okay? Each one we can contain 1 kilo entry, right? Each physical page can contain 1 kilo PT entry. Okay, so how many pages in total we need in order to contain this page table? Okay, so our page, so you can see this is in total we need 1 mega entry, right? This is a total entry. Total PT entry. Okay, then PT entry are put into the page. Then each page can contain 1 kilo, right? So 1 mega in total, right? Each page can contain 1 kilo, right? So in total, how many physical page we need? 1 kilo, okay? 1 kilo page, okay. So you can think about we may need 1 kilo page here to put, right? But in order to refer this 1 kilo pages, PT entry size is what? Okay, this is the PT entry size, right? How many bits we need, right? You think about that. Okay, the offset here. So the first one, 12 is 4 kilobytes, 2 power 12, right? Second part, our offset here, 1 kilo, 2 power 10. Then the remainder is our page directory entry, is 10 bits. But you can also see here, 1 kilo entries. Then we can use one page, one physical page to contain all entries, right? So that means for each process now, we can have one physical page for page directory. Then we may have one page for our code, one page for the heap, one page for the, stack. Then correspondingly, we allocate some physical page to contain real data, right? Then we are okay, we can run this process, right? But see, my message here is that how to determine those, how many bits we need. For example, for offset, this totally relate to the page size. So go to the page size, then we can determine how many bits we need in our virtual address. For example, 4 kilobytes, then 2^12, right? 4 kilo, which is 2^12. So we have 12 bits. This is the use. You can see this 12 bits is go to here to go to the offsite, right? To find our physical address inside the page. Then next, how many bits is go to our page table offsite, inside our page, for example, here, this one, table offsite, right? After we have this page table entry, then how many bits for the offsite? This one, we can use page PT entry size and our page size, right here. Page size, 4 kilobytes. PT entry, 4 bytes. So we have 1 kilo. So we have 10 bits. Okay, then the remaining bits are for our directory. Now certainly you can extend this to multiple level, right? You can extend this to multiple level. But generally speaking, that's how we do it. So why this is important? Important thing is that after we have this virtual address, then based on our table, for example, this is our table here, right? This is our page directory page. Then we know how many bits we need as offsite inside this page directory. For example, here, you can see based on this directory entry offsite, then we can decide it, oh, this page frame is used to contain our corresponding page table, right? Then go to this page, physical page, then use this, the second part. This is for the table offset. Then decide which physical page is used to contain our real data, right? Then use this part plus our offset. Then finally we get the physical. I hope this can help you, but don't worry, you have a homework to do. Okay, after you finish homework, then you should be clear. And also, tutor will talk about this, not only for this two level, we also introduce multiple level and also help you to figure out how to filter in our page table, okay, page table entry and so on. Okay, so this part is important. Usually we will put one question in the final exam, which is related to kind of how to fill up the page mapping table, which part is virtual address and so on. Of course, it's not that simple, but generally speaking, that's the question here. Okay, so what I discuss actually is here. I'm sorry, I should utilize this one. For example, for the IE32 architecture, this is exactly I'm talking about. Each page is 4 kilobytes. Okay, so 12 bits represent offset from if we use hex decimal, which is 0002FFF. Okay, the virtual address space process 4 gigabytes. Okay, then each entry in the page table is 4 bytes. Then how big for page table? Relate to one process, which means we want to map 4 gigabytes virtual address to 4 gigabytes physical space. Then to answer this question, we first look at how many entries in the page table. So basically in total, we have 4 gigabytes. Then our page table size is four kilobytes. So we need one mega entry, page table entry, right? Then this page table size is 4 megabytes, 1 mega times four bytes. Okay. So if we have 1,000, then basically we have 4 gigabytes. Then however, if we have 1 mega entry, then if we have one more level, then how many bits we need, right? So I already talked about, right? Generally speaking is that each page can contain, each page is 4 kilobytes. Then if each page entry is 4 bytes, So one page, okay, one page can contain 1024 entries, PT entry, right? Okay, so that means we have our offset. When we go to a particular page, our offset 10 bits. Okay, so this is why we go to this address space. You can see this address space basically is 12 bits for offset. Then this 10 bits for our table, page table offset, right? The remainder in total is 32 bits. So another 10 bits is used for page directory offset, page directory entry offset, right? Then certainly we have a register tell us where is our base address, page directory, base register. Then from there, then basically everything works. Okay, so let me go through some examples. I will go back to this one later. Okay, I noticed there are some questions, but let me go through some simple example. I hope it can help you to understand this part better. Then I will go back to answer some questions. So notice I put some example slides here in lecture 10, okay? Lecture 10, under this slides, I put an example, okay? So those example is basically already download, so I just want to let me directly open it so we can simply go through it. So just want to give you some example that you help you to understand this part. So suppose our physical memory here, we only have 32 bytes, our physical memory, okay? Then this is our process one, virtual space. You can see our virtual space is 16 bytes. Then use base and bound. Basically, we can put this into different location. For example, if base is 5, then our process virtual address is translated into here, right? You can see here, right? If base is 11, then basically that means we will we'll put this address here, right? Similarly, if base is 1, we'll put it here, right? Then the question is that if virtual address is 8, then what is the corresponding physical address? Then you can see it's here, right? 8 is here, right? 8 is here. So use base and bound to do the translation is very simple. It's just plus, given the virtual address, plus the base, you get the physical address. For example, 13 here, 19 here, 11 plus 8, right? 1 is 9, right? You can see perfectly, right? So base and bound is simple. However, you can see in order to make it work, we have to load the whole address space. We have to allocate the whole physical space for the whole virtual space, right? So that's an issue. Then we go to segmentation. So similar example, you can see here, we still have a virtual address 16, okay? Our physical memory also is 32, okay? Now we want to do allocation, memory allocation, okay? You can see here, if you use our segmentation like this, right? Basically, we can, based on this table, because here, for each process, then we look at the component code, heap, and stack. Then do base and bond correspondingly. Okay, then the good thing here is that you can see from this example, it clearly shows that we have better space utilization before, because our virtual address space is 16, then our physical address is 32. At most, we can only run two processes, right? However, use our segmentation, because we only allocate the space for each component, then actually from this example, now we can run three processes at the same time. Of course, that means some space, some virtual space, actually we didn't allocate any physical space, right? So that's why it works, right? So, but anyway, so you can see here, our mapping is for the process one code segment is allocated to this part, right? You can see here, right? For our heap segment, heap is allocated into six, right? Heap is 28, right? Heap is here, right? Heap is here, okay? Then our stack is 9. So basically our stack is here, right? 9. However, stack is, the direction is go up. So go this direction, right? Basically, this is what we discussed. For the stack, we have a different direction. Okay, so question is, for the virtual address 6, how to find the corresponding physical address? Certainly, because we already know this is in heap, heap is allocated into 28 here, right? Then if we have virtual address 6 here, then we know the physical address is 30, right? We already know. But the question is how to do it, right? So first we have to know the offset inside the heap. So for this virtual address 6, we cannot directly use this one as we used in the base and bound, because now we have to look at the offset inside the heap. So generally speaking, we know, oh, this is in the heap. So the offset here is 2 inside the heap. Then our heap, the base is 28. So now base and bound, 2 plus 28, then we got 30. Okay. Right, correct, right? So similarly, you can get other address, right? For example, maybe I ask you, what is the virtual address 14? What is virtual address 14? How to do calculation? Of course, I know this is 8, right? But how to do calculation, right? Maybe because of time, okay, let me quickly go through this. Maybe we can directly, of course we have many different ways to do it, but our base, stack, our base is bottom of the stack, right? Which is 15. So here our offset is minus 1 based on our bottom, right? Minus 1, right? So, oh, you can make it y also is okay, right? It doesn't matter. It depends on how you look at this number, right? But our base is 9. 9 minus 1 is 8. That's it. So generally speaking, we also calculate the index. However, we just subtract from our base. Then we get the physical address. Okay. Yeah, so this is a kind of simple stuff. Let's go to the paging. So similarly, if we go to page, you can see that our physical page, first we make it become, we call it physical frame number. So you can see that 0, 1, suppose each page is 4 bytes, then you can see this is how we do it, right? Basically, this in total we have 32 bits, and each page contains 4 bytes. So in total we have 8 entries. So we use 0 to 7 to represent our physical frame number. Okay, then this part is our virtual address space. Similarly, we also divide our virtual address space based on the 4 bytes page size. So we have virtual page 0, 1, 2, 3, okay, each one. Then for each process, we need to build up a mapping table. For example, in this case, for process one, we have for the virtual page 0, we go to the physical page 0. For the virtual page 1, we go to 7 and so on, right? 0, 7, 5, 3. And similarly for the mapping here, we have 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so the result is like this. Okay, first the divide into the, based on the page size, then do the allocation based on page table, right? Correspondingly, then we have each process, we have page table, then everything can be solved, right? However, we need to store our page table, right? Page table is part of our memory. So we have to put this page table into the memory, then use PTBR, page table base register, to tell us the starting location of our page table. Then we can store our data based on the page table, right? So this hopefully this can help you to understand better about this kind of mapping, right? So this is simple stuff. Let me go back to look at this. Suppose we have multiple entry, right? Multiple level page table, right? So similar example here. Here we have to have a page directory, PDBR, page directory base register to tell us where to store our PDR, right? So in this case, because we only need one entry, because our address space is small. So just give a very simple example. For each one, for each process, we need to know what is the PDBR. For example, in this case, PDDR is 0 because we only need one entry, okay? So then for PDDR, for the process 2, PDR is 1, okay? For process 3, PDR is 2. So then we put this corresponding our page table 1, 2, 3, right? Then after we have this 1, 2, 3, this, so here 1, 2, 3, for example, this one doesn't mean we will directly utilize this to store data. This is our page table, our real page table, right? Okay, similarly for the process 2, this is a process 2 page table and so, right? Then from here, you can see from our page table, then our virtual page 0 will be stored into 4, right? So this is the one you can see here to store the 4, right? So similarly for process 2, the first page started to 5. Then for the process 3, the first page is stored into the 6 and so on. So the follow that we can do the mapping. Okay, so with this, let me conclude today's lecture. So yesterday, actually we talked about TLB. Generally speaking, TLB is used to speed up the translation. Okay, the idea also is very simple. We have small buffer. It's part of our MMU hardware. Then this can cache the popular virtual to physical address translation entry into this small buffer. Okay, so in this way, we can directly get the translation if we have a TLB hit. So TLB is for the performance. Then we also talk about the size, how to solve the size. generally speaking, we have several methods, but the most widely used method is multiple level pick table. Okay, so after we divide this into multiple level, then we only allocate page, allocate the physical space for the page table on demand. So in this way, we can reduce the physical space required for store the page table. Okay, so I think I will talk about the other topic, swap, those kind of issue next time. Then quickly finish that part, then we will go to the concurrency, okay? So that's all for today's lecture. Don't forget today's tutorial, which is very important for you to finish assignment four. So I'm going to answer some questions. So please input your question into chat box, or you can directly ask through the microphone. Okay. So that's all for today's lecture. Then if you want to continue for the QA session, then please stay. Otherwise, you can leave. Okay, so where is the TLB stored? Yeah, that's a very good question. So TLB is part of the MMU, which is, so MMU is inside the CPU, okay. Yeah, on the CPU chip or something like that. So generally speaking, TLB is a kind of hardware unit, which is a part of our memory unit, which is a part of our CPU. Okay, it's a hardware. So in one word, okay, it's stored inside CPU, okay. Yeah, so another question is, let me first clean up some question here. Great. So for indirectly mapping, TLB saves the mapping to PTE or page table. Yeah, TLB can only store the mapping, right? Virtual page number to physical page number, right? Physical page number, PTE, right? VPN to PFN, right? So basically this, so for indirect mapping, still it only store the mapping. It only store mapping. There's no PTE entry over there. So basically it can help us to speed up this translation, right? For this translation, where to find our physical page, right? Yeah, I think your question is, why do we really need this TLB? Is this your question? So generally speaking, we need to know where is our page directory page, right? So for that page, actually, we also need to do the translation. So that's what I'm talking about. Yeah, I will answer the question later, okay? What are the flag in the page table? Okay, what are the flag in the page table? I think, are you talking about the, what do you mean the flag? You mean PT entry flag? Huh? Hello? Yeah, so if you talk about, because page table actually used to contain PT entry, right? Then you go to look at the PT entry, then you can see those flags meaning, right? For example, it may inside the page table for each we may have a we may store PFN and also some flags. For example, dirty, access, present, and so on, right? Valid, and so on, right? Yeah. So I think this question is related to the kind of like how to calculate the address. So I think we already solved this, yeah. Oh, so are you talking about TIB entry? Yeah, so, yeah, I think maybe let me copy some question, then I go back. I find out I have to somehow go back to like this way to copy the question, then I can copy the question. Otherwise, I could not copy the question. Okay, so let me clean this and copy some new question here. Is there only one page table in direct mapping? It's the same as direct. I don't understand this question. So can you clarify the question? Huh? Yeah, I think let me wait for the first question, okay, to be clarified. So let's first look at this next question. How does the page directory do context page? Okay, so this is a very good question. So generally speaking, this is a very similar to our user one level page table, right? So we need to remember this called page PDPR, right? PDPR, base register, right? Page directory, base register. So every time for each process, we need to remember this one, right? Each one, each process has its own page table. So starting from this page directory page. So basically, this is the first part. Then when we do the context switch, we have to remember our PDPR, the address for this one. Where is my page table and so on, right? So when we do the context switch, we just switch the PDPR to so basically we store the PDPR into PCB and resume PDPR from PCB. Right, of course, this is two process, right? Suppose this is a B. We want to switch from A to B. So basically we store the current PDBR address into the PCB of process A, then resume PDDR from the PCB of the process B, process control block, right? Generally speaking, we store this value somewhere in our process structure, right? Then later we can do switch. Related to the question, TRB entry flag, right? TRB entry. So generally speaking, we will store some flag from PTE flag into TRB, right? So because think about that, okay, TRB actually is used to cache PTE. So certainly we need to contain several bits related flag we should put into TRB entry, right? Yeah, I hope I answer your question here. So then go back to this one. If there's only one page table in direct mapping, it's the same as direct mapping. I now understand your question. Your question is that, so if we only have There's only one pre-depo in direct mapping. The same as direct mapping. I don't know your question. So generally speaking, our page table, we need physical pages to contain our page table, right? Then we add a directory entry, directory page. Then for those entries, we don't need to empty entries. Those pages contain empty entries, right? Totally pages are empty. So we don't need to allocate physical space, right? So that's what we are talking about in direction, right? How TLB deal with those layer? TLB will only handle the kind of a mapping, right? So basically, TLB cannot recognize the different, I think maybe this is the very cool question. Let me go back to copy some question. I think you guys asked a very good question. I think I already answered several questions. Let me remove those questions. So maybe I start from here. So TIB also stop PT entry. Yes, partially, because TIB is used to contain those. Actually, I don't quite understand how TIB works. Okay, basically, whenever you have this virtual address to physical address mapping, then you use TLB, right? TLB just used to store the mapping. Return VPN to PFN, right? So if we have one more level, then inside that page also contain those mapping, right? For example, suppose our page directory, we have one page contain for page directory, for page directory, right? Then, so this page actually can also contain the mapping, right? Between virtual address to physical address, right? Think about that. So that's it, right? Just for this virtual address, you just go here to find the corresponding physical address. So similarly, for those VPN, go to the PFN, then we will store this entry into TLB. So in other words, PD, page directory entry, right? We also have, this is not directly, is not our page table entry, but it's kind of, we call PP, page entry, right? Something like PPE, something like that. But this is also for the mapping, right? So basically we want to have this kind of mapping. Where is PDPR? So PDPR actually is a register, a hardware. Okay, so a CPU hardware. Usually is a register, okay, special register. It's like our other register, like our general purpose register and so on. So we have a register called PDPR. But in different system, we may have different name, right? For example, in Intel, we call CR3. Control register 3 is for PDPR. Actually, it's our PDPR, right? CR3. control registry. Right? Different system may have different name. Because we have more layers before we get to VPN, but see, okay, what I'm saying is that it doesn't matter. TRB only care about the mapping. TRB cannot remember, will not distinguish the different layer, right? So this is go to your question. Basically, for TRB, for different level, actually, to speed up for each level, we can also have a TRB. So this depends on the design. For example, for the whole system, we have one TRB to do the translation. Or you can, for a particular level, we have a TRB and help us to speed up this translation. Okay. What is a PCB? PCB, process control block. So basically, this is this structure to contain all information of a process, right? Yeah, I think maybe I answered our question. Hopefully. Let me go back to answer my question here. Okay. What is, I think I answered those questions. How TRB deal with these layers? As I mentioned, okay, basically TRB is used to store the mapping, right? So it doesn't matter. So one way is we don't care about the layers. So it just contain those translation is okay. Because when you look at this virtual address, then you should go to this physical address. That's it. This kind of mapping, as long as we know this mapping is okay, right? So basically we contain this mapping. Then if you want to go to this address, then you will do this to contain this mapping. That's it, right? So is the PCB this structure for each process? Yes. Generally speaking, yes, right? So this is a very good question. I think it relates to the multiple level VPN to PFN mapping, right? So generally speaking, TRB can store multiple level. Yeah, so in principle, this is okay. Or we can do some optimization. So in terms of a real implementation, a different process may have different way to handle. Right. So for example, for different level, maybe have a TRB that can help us to do this translation, right? But generally speaking, we can handle multiple level, right? Yeah, is multiple level for different levels. So it's possible. Yeah, I think this is the one for optimization issue. So it's possible to have multiple, each level we have one TRB, yeah. Why, last question, why TRB does not store virtual physical address transfer? So what do we mean? You mean why we don't directly store this virtual translation? I don't understand your question actually. Certainly we will do it, right? So that's the whole purpose of TRB is to store the virtual address to physical address translation, right? But the question is that we could not find it, then we have to go to our PDT, go to our page directory, page or go to our page table page to find it. If we already have it, we already have the entry, this virtual address to physical address, we will go there to find it. The problem is that we could not find it. Think about that. Then you have to go to do more translation because you need to look at those translation, right? That's what I'm talking about. PFN, PFN is physical frame number, which is our physical address, right? PFN is a physical address. PFN is not a PF because our PFN, so let me clarify, okay. PFN is a physical address. Physical page number, basically, right? So because our physical space already divided into physical page, then PFN page frame number actually is referred to a physical page. This is a physical address. Of course, if you want to go to the specific physical address, because we also need the offset, right? In direct mapping, okay. Yeah, so let's go back to our whole purpose. Where is the offset is the PFN? So what I talk about? Which one you are talking about? Which slides? I think you have to give me a specific one you are talking about. Yeah, maybe to answer your question, we have to go back to the slides right here to look at. So the whole idea here is that we want to, we want to reduce the space. So remember the first we start, we directly start the mapping, right? From VPN to PFN. We want to have multiple level. The reason is that we want to save the space. Huh? That's the whole purpose, right? So we end this interaction. We want to save the space, right? Did I answer your question? Hello? Right? So the whole idea here is that we want to have multiple levels to save the space. So if we don't want to save the space, we can directly save the mapping. Yeah. One level is okay, but it occupies too much space. So we want to add one more level. We have directory page. Then this direct page helps us to find the, to save the space because through this directory page, then basically we don't need to like, I think somewhere I put this, yeah. But not this, not this one, sorry. So this one. Yeah, somehow this is not clear. But generally speaking, this whole idea is like this, right? We want to add one more level so we don't need to store those empty pages for our mapping table, or we just allocate the physical page on demand for our page table, then we can save the space. But we can directly save this page table as this one, right? But it wastes our space. Okay, so any other questions? No more question, huh? Okay. Thank you guys. See you next week.